Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're a free-to-play player, Pastures is back in action!
Xyron is here. Alright, and today we're going to talk about Gilgamesh Trial! And we are really excited because this is look at the reward. The first clear reward says it's a Genji sword.
Awesome!
And it's attack plus 107, alright? That's the best katana that we have in the business. I can't wait for it. I'm gonna get my blade mastery from Chizuru. 50% attack boost along with attack plus 107, and it's free! Alright, and the energy required is 40. And in one of the bloopers, I mentioned that if our friend started an FFBE account, she wouldn't even be able to play this because it requires 40 energy. Pastures, what is your maximum energy capacity?
86 maybe.
Okay, so basically he only has two chances at this. There's one battle, so that's a good thing, unlike much of the beasts. The guild that you get is retarded, we don't really need to talk about that. Alright, that's all. Let's talk about the mission clear rewards, okay? So, I've heard rumors that the clear quest reward is actually a 100 lapis given, and we always want lapis because we're free to play players.
But it's only 100, it's not really worth it. But okay, at least you get something.
Yeah, but this is the one that takes the cake. If you kill Gilgamesh with a limit burst, you get a
5-star trust Moogle!
And it's 10% trust. I really need that for, like what I mentioned, my Chizuru as well as my Dark Mill.
Yeah.
Right, so, and next up, this is really difficult. 5 or less party members, you get attack 30%. I cannot wait to give my Noctis this so that my good friends Titus and all the other good friends I have in FFBE can use my Noctis to be the true whale that it's meant to be. Alright, and clearing without items.
Yes, then you have the secret art called Heaven Strike AoE Dispel. That's super awesome with unmitigated damage. That's up there with the top tier physical attackers. So, really, really good rewards here. However, I think that the 5-star Trust Moogle is a bit of a chicken and egg problem, because if you don't have at least 2 Trust Master rewards unlocked, if not 3, it's probably going to be impossible for you to clear this event.
And you need a good limit burst as well.
Yeah.
You probably want to, on the last part, use all your limit bursts so that they can kill Gilgamesh at one shot. It's gonna be a pain.
Yeah, so the thing is that we don't have innate dual cast healers yet. So you are going to need firstly dual wield for your attackers, and you're going to be needing a dual cast so that you can cast revive and heal.
Yes.
Or else buff and heal on the same turn.
Yeah.
So without these 2 Trust Master rewards, I'm not sure how people are going to be able to clear. And as well, you can expect really high defense from Gilgamesh because obviously he's heavily plated armor. So you're also going to be needing some attack boosters, and probably the best one is Blade Mastery. So if you don't have Blade Mastery as well, and you don't bump up your attack to at least the 700 range, you're probably going to be not doing enough damage to kill him.
Yeah, I think Gumi is sending us a message that they want to separate the boys from the men, and they want us to go through the trial of Gilgamesh to find out who we are and to sift out the good from the excellent, okay?
So what I would say, if you're a free-to-play player, you've been playing for the last half year or so, you probably have one Trustmaster reward unlocked already, and I hope that you got dual wield, and if you got Excalibur, that's new, okay? So, have at least dual wield, and what you need to be doing is start farming then for your second or third Trustmaster reward, okay? What you really need to unlock right now is dual cast, so that should be your top priority. But you should start Trustmaster farming using Earth Shrine, 1 energy each turn, and try to unlock, if you have enough Chizurus, 4 or 5, get Blade Mastery. If not, try and get a good weapon like Excalibur, etc. etc. Okay, so you really need to conserve your trust mookers, because this 5-star trust mooker is not going to help you unless you grind out your trust master reward. So that's my advice for you.
Yeah, and definitely Pastures and Xyron will come up with maybe an individual or a collab to show you how to get that attack plus 30%. That is the real prize, alright? As well as the katana, and eventually maybe even a video on how to get a 5% trust book.
Okay, so you need Man-Eater plus, I would say that Cloud of Darkness is a necessity here. And if you at all possible, what you should try and do is bump your Cloud of Darkness attack up to at least 600, and with Man-Eater plus you'll do pretty good damage. And how you do that is dual wield with Rising Sun, which locks Trust Master reward. Not easy, you're talking about many, many Trust Masters, so probably free to play player, you won't be able to get Cloud Dunners up there. But what is doable is getting a 2-star Golem Esper with Provoke, and you really, really need that.
Yes.
So, as well, you can see over here that he has all sorts of elemental damage: Holy, Fire, Water, Wind, Earth. And in combination with that, he also gets some abilities off with those elemental attacks. So you can see that with fire, if he uses Demon Sword Masamune, he has Osmos, so he can like totally drain the MP from one of your units. And what else? He has Holy 100% chance to confuse. Where's the paralysis? Wind is 100% chance to paralyze, and minus resistance of quite a few elements. So you, the recommended strategy here, and I have to agree with this, is that you have to keep on using fire, wind, and holy damage on all your turns.
Yeah.
So here is what I'm thinking for now. I haven't actually tried it yet, obviously, but with fire, that's pretty easy. Almost anything can use fire.
Yeah.
Because if you use the element, he won't use the element to attack, okay?
Yes.
So as long as you have, for example, Chi-Chi rather than equipped or any other fire sword, it's fine. If you're not in his fire flask, that's good, okay? Wind...
a bit difficult.
Wind is a bit difficult, but if you have already a Gilgamesh, use Gilgamesh on... to fight Gilgamesh, then fight fire with fire, or wind with wind, as it were. And if not, you can use Bats, okay?
Yeah, Bats, yes.
And Holy, I think... that is not too hard, because if you have Cecil or
Backstep
or Refear, you can already just use Banish. Just simply, even though it doesn't do any damage, but it will stop Gilgamesh from casting the Holy attack. If not, X-Death has Wicked Light. However, Wicked Light is really, really expensive. You're gonna have to keep on trying to, and you can't really dual cast it, because you dual cast, it's going to be on your Refear to raise and heal at the same time.
Yeah, and you need the Provoke so that the attacks of Gilgamesh will be centered around that one person. So if on that turn you are not able to do your fire, wind, or holy damage, or even water damage, the Osmos would happen on that poor, foolish unit that you put Provoke on. In my case, it would be Sissel, probably. So I have to make sure that Sissel is not playing any other role other than tank in this fight. Alright, and so let's move on. At 80%, 50%, and 30%, as shown in the image, Gilgamesh will use his secret skill, and he can reduce the damage with defense spirit buffs and attack magic breaks. So it's important and absolutely essential that you bring your buffs. I'm thinking Riffia and Sissel with Focus and Embolden as per normal. I believe now there's also Ling that can buff your team up. Any other units you have to recommend for buffing?
Ling is a debuffer. I would not recommend bringing Rain, although he has leadership and undermine, because Rain just doesn't have good enough stats to withstand those elite bosses. But the good thing about this event is that none of them have a clear without an ally being KO achievement.
Yeah.
So it's possible, but I think with Riffy and Cecil, you are double up and you're wasting a unit slot by bringing Rain.
Yeah, and following that, they are also saying that we need to buy safety bits. This is in the new map that is coming out on Thursday in Mycelia, in a secret chocobo shop, to prevent instant KO. So it seems as if there's an instant KO move that Gilgamesh can do, and can get it from Mycelia. So I guess just keep your star cards ready.
Yeah. And so, yeah, I think that's about it.
Yeah. You know, and the thing about that's so attractive about this trial is that it is giving a katana.
Secret art heaven strike instant KO to a single target.
Yeah.
So that's why you need dual cast on your leaf here.
So that you can full life on one and then Kuraja.
Make sure you bring Noctis or have him in your team, if not use him as an ally, so you have two people who can full raise at least.
Yeah. And the other thing that you should probably consider is actually doing this this mission one quest at a time, because it's going to be such a pain trying to do everything at one turn. Probably you want to just clear it first, get the katana, come back another day to do the limit burst one and the final next party members.
Yes, and if you have to use items, just use the items, don't worry about it.
Yeah, yeah, that's all I have.
It's going to take you how long to clear this fight?
I've heard that it'll take hours, you know, so I'm
two
excited.
Hours,
I'm crazy. Excited about it. For much of the beast, I took about half an hour.
This is only for pro players, guys.
Yeah, so if you are a free-to-play player and you're bored right now, prepare your team for battle. Gilgamesh is here.
Prepare yourself.
Right.
For the hurt. Alright, so that's it for us. Keep the faith. Peace out.